So you've heard about TPT Easel, but you're thinking, what is it? And does it really apply to me as a TPT seller? Stick around because I will explain what I have learned about it so far, and I'll give you a little bit of a tutorial. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, my name is Lorianne, and if you are new to this channel, welcome. Here at It's All Primary, we talk all things related to teacher side hustles. And today we are talking about Teacher Pay Teacher's newest endeavor product. I don't know what to call it. TPT Easel. Now, a couple weeks back, I started seeing a banner when I would go into the Teachers Pay Teacher's marketplace. And then maybe a week and a half ago, during another video, Leslie over at Teach Kids Music asked me, what do you think of TPT Easel? And I had to honestly think, nothing. I haven't thought, I don't know anything about it. So I went on to TPT Easel, did the whole tutorial, watched the videos, and then I got on it a little bit more seriously, played with it, started creating. So here I am now. And you might be asking whether TPT Easel is TPT Digital Activities regurgitated. Maybe. I'll be honest, okay? I never used the digital activities component. I just made the decision to make Google Slides and to create boom cards. But what you do with TPT Easel, it's a device-based learning platform, much in the way that Boom Learning is. Boom Learning, you don't download stuff. Everything stays on Boom Learning. The same applies to Easel. There's no printing involved. There is no downloading it here, marking it, uploading it. There's none of that. Everything stays on Easel. As a seller, I would have my product, which is a PDF, I would have my product listed. The person would buy it, and if they open it up as a Easel activity, I think that's what they call it, it doesn't leave Easel. So the teacher would then assign students the activity. The students would have to log in to Easel, complete it there, and then the teacher would mark it, review it in Easel. It never leaves the platform. Now, Easel does not apply to Google Slides that you've created, to Boom Cards that you've created, or any products that involve a zip file. You can only opt in to Easel with a single PDF resource. I'm going to turn the camera in just a minute and I'm going to show you a few things. This is one of my thoughts. Some teachers may just opt in to Easel and leave their product as is. As a buyer, that will frustrate me, because if I'm going to purchase something as an Easel activity, then I'm hoping that they have added the boxes and added the shapes or whatever it is that I'm moving around, that it's already been done. One thing that they're selling in, as part of Easel, is that the buyer or the seller can add the movable features. And some sellers may think, great, I can just sell it as a movable feature, but I'm not going to do it. I'm going to let the buyer do it. But if I was the buyer and I went in and there were no movable features and I had to add them myself, personally, I'd be like, I'm giving you a bad review. I really would, because I'm thinking you're making me do the work for your product. And I'll give you an example. They give a small list of some activities that are Easel ready. And so I installed one and I went into Easel and there was nothing added to it. The product was just a PDF document. And I thought, so I've got to go in there and add all the boxes and I have to add all the little things. I'm not interested in buying products that way. And I think that's one of the things that you need to be careful about if you are going to put a product and list it as an Easel product, if you have not done the work. And as you can see, the banner up above here, Easel by TPT. How you get there, I just click on Easel by TPT at the top. So they're talking about device-based resources, turn your PDFs into interactive device-based activities, and you can add interactive elements. So we're going to go up to get started. Here is where you opt in or opt out. So for example, this Google Slides is not an opt-in. So right now I've opted out and all my other Google Slide resources are all opted out. But down here at the bottom, I've started working on this one right here. So these three here are PDFs, single PDFs, so I can opt in. And then farther down, these are I've opted out of as a Google Slides. I can create easel with this one. I've opted out of these two. I can opt in with these. And I'm leaving the rest of them right now. I have 6 currently available to be part of Easel. So if I decide to opt out of this, all I have to do is go where the 3 dots are, and there it is, opt out. But let's go back to this, and I've got it, as you can see, an unpublished draft. This is what I've been working on, and that is the adding of boxes for writing. On the side here, you select the ones that you want to use as part of Easel. So I've already deselected instructions, things like that, that are for the teacher. If you have answer boxes, you want to make sure they're out of here. So again, I've just been playing around with this. You can't see it on the right side over here, but there is a plus sign and a minus sign, and that is just to increase or decrease the products. Whoops. I've added boxes here, and all I did was I hit select, but let me go to another one here. I've done that one already. But what I've done here, let me erase these and I'll just show you what I did. So I clicked over here to answer box, and then I just dragged it right on the line, and it's still selected, so I'm just going to do it again. You do not have the option of fonts. You have the option of a size of font, but you do not have the option of fonts. Here on this page where they are would normally circle the correct, I can add a piece of text right here to say drag the circle to the correct number. So I can type. So I'm making an annotated box. Drag the circles to the correct answer or something like that. And I can just move that when you get the dots. So I can put it right on top of it, or I could probably put it there, right? I'll put it here for now. And then how I made these is I went up to shape. And as you can see, these are the 3 options for shapes. I dragged a circle, and it's not movable until these are green. So I clicked up to here where it says movable, and now it's green. That makes it movable. Okay, and these ones are green, so they're movable. So I'm going to just get rid of that one. So I've done that on this page. I'll scroll down. I haven't done this one. Again, I can make a shape. I can make it movable. Whoops, it already was for some reason. But that is all you can do that I can see so far. I'm not sure. I'm trying to figure out how to maybe fill in boxes with color for students. On one of these before and after, I would just answer box. Put in an answer box here, and I just put answer boxes all the way down. Easel is in its infancy right now. I think there are plans down the road, but I don't work for TPT, so I don't know for sure. And if those plans, when those plans would happen. This is one where I was trying to figure out what I could do, whether I could create a shape right on this box, and then I don't need it movable, so I'm going to unclick that movable, but if they could fill in the shape. You could get your students to color in the boxes that way. So again, shape of the circle. I see now they're all colored in. I don't want them all colored in, so I've got to, it seems to keep what the last action you did. Okay, so students can color in the circles, which is good to know, but they wouldn't be able to color in these animals very well. I could change the annotation to say, cover the animals with a square or something like that. I don't know. I'd have to make it small and fill it in. Let's do orange. Then I gotta make it movable. So it'd be like, cover the animal with an orange box. Something like that. Oops. I know it's very sensitive. Before we get out of here, if you want to see what the students will see, you just go up to preview. Just go up to the arrows to find the page you want to look at. Let's make it a little bit smaller for you to see, right? So then they can preview it. Oh, that's circling the answer. 5, 2. And then when you are completely finished, you can publish it. When you publish it, you will have in your store, in order to get back out to TPT, if you look up ahead, up above, you will find that the easel had opened its own window. So I just closed the window and we're back to TPT. And then I can go back to my store. Seen so far, I don't know how much of this I would actually use. I may do those PDF resources that I have, but it's not going to be a rush I think what I'm going to do is opt out of all my resources and see what happens between now and the summer. There's no audio instructions available. I did see on a slide, and I can't remember where I saw it, but it looks like there's going to be a membership for Easel. And again, it's coming. So I'm not sure what I would do with this. I prefer Boom. I like the ease of it. You can do a lot more things with this. You can't upload, as I said, your own fonts. You can't upload images or animated things yet. I think those are coming, as I've said. But right now, where it stands, I'm just going to probably keep it on the shelf and decide what to do later. If you are getting any value from this video, please click that thumb up and subscribe here at It's All Primary. Teacher side hustle videos are posted Tuesdays and Saturdays. With next week's video, we are going back to Boom cards. There have been some slight updates that have happened with them. I've learned a few more things and I'm excited to show you. So Boom cards is next weekend. Woohoo! So wherever you are in the world, I hope you and your family are staying safe and being healthy. And we will catch you in the next video. Check them out. Take care, everyone.